We are at E3, Downtown Los Angeles Convention Center here in sunny Southern California. And with me is Patricia Vance with the ESRB. And for those watching, this is really important, moms, because we're talking about games and the rating systems for games. Can you explain to us what that means, ESRB?
Yes, well, it stands for the Entertainment Software Rating Board. And we've been around for now almost 20 years of assigning age ratings and content descriptors to virtually all the games that are sold in the United States and Canada, by the way.
The gaming industry is very different from where we were 20 years ago. Can you talk about what you do specifically?
Well, games are very sophisticated now, as you know. We have very large, big blockbuster games that are very complicated and you can spend 10, 20, 30 hours playing games. And frankly, they're for all ages. They're not just for kids. But the average age of a gamer today is over 30.
Isn't that amazing?
And that often comes as a surprise to parents when we start talking about the rating system. And I use that statistic because it reinforces the importance of the ratings.
So let's break it down.
So we start with EC for early childhood, E for everyone, then E10 plus for everyone 10 and older, T for teen, 13 and over, M for mature for 17 and older, and then AO for adults only, which is 18 and older. Publishers come to us to submit a game for rating. The visual material is put in front of raters. And what happens is the raters will look at the game, will vote on a particular rating assignment. The consensus of that end vote is what ultimately gets the rating. It's really important for parents to know that, you know, we have a number of different resources, starting, you know, from the top, the age rating, which will give you a general sense of the age appropriateness, the content descriptors, which will give you an indication as to what type of content may have triggered an age rating, and now our rating summaries, which are available through our website, as well as through a free mobile app that parents can download and use it right there in the store.
Which is really an amazing new thing, actually, which I did download. And so you just download the app, it's free.
Yes.
And then...
So you have three ways to search for game information or our rating summary. One is just typing in the name of the game, and that will immediately call up the rating summary. Second way is to just say the name of the game into your phone, and it will immediately bring up that rating summary. Or what's really cool is you can take a picture of the front of the box of the game and call up the rating summary that way. So the mobile app is a great tool for parents, particularly when they're out shopping.
Okay, I want you to put your mommy hat on.
Yeah.
What advice would you give parents as far as being more aware of what they're doing out there on the internet, gaming and whatnot?
Well, I think the most important piece of advice would probably get the consoles and computers out of the bedrooms. Put them in public spaces in the house so that you can see what your child's doing. Second thing would be to set parental controls. And the third thing is just, you know, set some rules. Talk to your kids about the things that you really don't want them doing on the internet. They need to have that open dialogue and open communication with their kids. But parents should be parents. Parents should be able to set rules and talk to their kids about what the expectations are. Mm-hmm. If you're going to be allowed to use the computer or you're going to be playing games, these are the rules.
All right, Patricia, thank you so much for that information. And of course, if you want more information, all you have to do is go to esrb.org. We're going to have the link right here, so you can click that. And of course, comment. We love to hear from you. Send us any questions and let us know what you think. All right, it's Maria from Mommy Loves Tech. We'll see you next time.